Discussions comparing Claude Code with OpenAI's Codex are getting heated, with people even accusing each other of being bots. In this video, I wanted to give my own try at comparing Claude Code with Codex and letting you in on the secret that all these six-figure actual senior engineers know about when it comes to AI coding and chasing all these latest shiniest tools. And by the end of this video, you'll know just as much as me when it comes to chasing the hype. So how do we compare and contrast Claude Code with OpenAI's Codex? Well, for that, I'm using this demo application here that allows you to create an auction in both Python and Java. And I use this application a lot to showcase the difference between these two languages and how it's like to do AI coding together with them. So what I can basically do here is create a new auction. And then once I've done so, you can actually see that I can create bids on this Raspberry Pi cluster kit. So let's go ahead and actually bid $230 here with Python P. And you can see indeed that I'm now the highest bidder. There is also a buyout price. So in theory, if I bid $260, I should immediately be able to get this Raspberry Pi cluster kit. If I bid $260, then you do see that actually I am the highest bidder, but the auction isn't closed. And in fact, Python Pete is able to just bid a ridiculous amount of money and still be the highest bidder. So something's going wrong here, right? Actually, the thing is, in my code, in both the Python version as well as the Java version, I introduced a bug on purpose. Basically, what I'm doing here is I am assigning the closed status to an unused variable instead of actually changing the status of the auction object itself. So when I commit the latest version of the auction object, the status is not actually set to closed. And I'm introducing this exact same bug in both Python as well as Java. You can see it here as well, where status is actually a variable that's never read or really used in a repository at all. Now, the reason why I introduced this bug on purpose in these two different languages is just to showcase whether Claude Code and Codex can pick up on this exact same bug across two different languages without me explicitly instructing it to find it. So what we're going to be doing here is we're actually going to be using OpenAI Codex here on the right. And then here on the left, I'm actually going to go ahead and start a Claude Code session. Now, I want to make sure that this is a fair game. So I actually have not connected either Claude Code or Codex to my IDE, so they don't know that the bug is in these files specifically. No need to worry about that. When it comes to the models that we'll be using, if you check out slash model here, you can see that I'm just selecting opus for every operation. And on the Codex side, let's actually go for GPT-5 high, effectively choosing the best model for both of these coding tools. So here we go. We can actually select both of those models. And then I'm going to paste the exact same prompt into both terminals. And I'm going to keep my prompt a little bit vague on purpose to see and challenge these models. So I'm going to say the buyout price option does not seem to work. Even if I bid that price or higher, the auction doesn't close. Now, in this specific prompt, I'm not actually directing the models to actually fix this for both the Python and the Java environments. I'm kind of expecting them to properly read the repository and actually figure that out for themselves. So now I've got the prompt in both of these models, and I'm going to go ahead and just submit them to both, and then we'll see how they are both going to actually try and solve this problem. Now, while these tools get working on the problem, I kind of wanted to have a discussion with you for a moment about how it can actually be a bit of a waste of time to even compare these tools directly, because before I even got started, I already showed you a couple of variables at play. You might have different programming languages for your project. You might be using different models next to the AI tools. And then the way that you prompt these models also really influences their behavior. So this is really not a be and end all test. In fact, there is no way to compare these kinds of tools together with each other because everyone's workflow is so very different. So in that case, I've kind of trapped you in this video, right? Because I'm comparing these two models, but at the same time, I'm telling you, there's not really a point in doing it. So then why am I creating a video like this when I don't even agree with the idea of directly testing these tools? Well, I just want to point out that all these AI tools are great tools for your toolbox, but in the end, they rely on your expertise as a developer. If, for example, you don't know any Java or Python at all, then these tools can be great if they help and solve a bug for you, but what if they don't? Every AI coding tool is going to break at one point or another. So if you don't actually know any programming yourself, you're going to get into trouble. This is not the message that the Vibe Coders or YouTuber are telling you, but as a senior engineer, I know what it's like to get stuck with these AI coding tools, and I can tell you that my real developer experience has helped me out of these ruts very often. As a senior engineer myself, I have seen how often these AI coding tools get stuck, and then I thank the stars for actually having the developer expertise to be able to guide the models into the right direction, and sometimes even just start coding manually. If you don't have the ability to do that as a developer, then you are going to get stuck very quickly. No matter what all the vibe coders on YouTube and other platforms are telling you, if you're working on real applications, then these AI coding tools are just a way for you to develop faster. They're not a full replacement for you as an engineer. That being said, it is very important to know how to use all of these tools correctly. And instead of going with all of the hype and trying to follow the latest trends, you should really pick the tool that makes you more productive and master it first before moving on to the next shiny thing. But with that being said, you are here to see a comparison between Claude Code and Codex, right? So let's actually have a look at how they both approach this problem. And to do that, let's go ahead and open up these terminals and extend them a lot more so we can see what's going on. And let's go ahead and scroll all the way to the top to see how both of these models actually approached it. Now, the nice thing about these AI native editors is that they are able to first actually have a look around the repository to explore the relevant files where something like buy price might be present. So you can see here that they basically both use a bunch of search methods to find examples of code where buyout is mentioned. And in this case, of course, something like Codex was a little bit more extensive in the types of search terms that it was looking for, but this is something that you could also prompt for, right? If you asked Claude Code to first do an extensive search with many keywords, it would pretty much do the same thing as Codex. So yes, Codex might have a slightly different behavior because GPT-5 might behave differently, but the prompting that you do matters a lot here as well. So in any case, they were both able to find some pretty relevant files, because if we scroll down here, you can actually see how they both edited logic in this case, the Python file first, and in Claude Code's case, the Java file first. And they are both doing a couple of things. So first of all, they actually double check if a bid meets or exceeds the buy now price. Of course, the code looks a little bit different between Java and Python, but we'll also be comparing the actual backend implementations in a little bit. In any case, from here, Claude Code should be checking the Python backend, whereas Codex still needs to do the Java implementation. So indeed, if I go ahead and scroll down here in the Codex implementation, we can see that the Java code is being picked up here, as well as the Python business logic here on the left in Claude Code. And they are both basically applying the same symbol fixes to both places. For example, you can see here how the status is now properly being applied to the auction object. So you can see here that the end result is pretty similar. To further confirm this, if we look at the Git tree here on the left and the right, we can see that the business logic Python file was indeed changed by both. Here on the left, Claude Code simply changed the auction status. Codex added a little comment. And if we scroll down, we can of course also see that there is some logic changes to actually compare whether the current bid is equal to or more than the buy now price. And if we check out the implementation, you can see it differs a little bit here and there in terms of the functions that are being used and the way that things are being logged, but the actual implementations are pretty similar. But honestly, the difference between these two models is just due to the non-deterministic nature of large language models. To prove that, I'm going to run the following experiment. Let's actually go ahead and undo the changes that Codex made. And now what I'm going to do is actually start a new Claude Code session inside of the Codex demo folder. And then I'm actually going to run the exact same prompt that I ran before. So we're going to do the exact same prompt here. I'm just going to show you that we are still using Opus. And then what you will see is that the implementation will differ slightly, even though we are using Claude Code. The point I'm trying to make here is that because of the non-deterministic nature of large language models, these singular tests are always a little bit silly, because even if you're using the exact same tool with the exact same prompt, the output is going to differ. And I can already start proving that to you while Claude Code is thinking, because if I make this window a bit bigger and compare it to the output of Claude Code here on the left, you can actually see how different it already tries to find code related to the buyout. You can see here that it uses different search terms. It starts with the same search pattern here, but then actually it starts to search for something different. Here it just looks for buyout price and buyout underscore price, whereas here you can see it's actually using a much different regex. Again, with the exact same prompt, it's behaving much differently. It actually placed more emphasis on the different backends in this case, whereas here on the left, it pretty much immediately just started to change the Java code. Now, if we go here to the right, you can actually see that it starts with checking the Python business logic. You can see here how the non-deterministic nature of these language models makes them behave super differently every time you test them with the same prompt, and that is what makes these tests so silly. Let's go ahead and accept all these changes, and then eventually we will see in our Git tree that the final implementation looks pretty different. Now that we have the changes on the left and the right side here, we can actually see that the Java implementation happens to be pretty similar, to be fair. I mean, the comment's slightly different, but the actual code implementation is the exact same. But I actually had a look at the Python code and something is really off here. If we check out the business logic Python file here, compared to the one here on the right, there is one big striking difference. There is an addition made here at the end of the file where it properly checks if the bid meets or exceeds the buy now price. But here's a really big issue. If we scroll up again, you can actually see that Claude Code this time did not pick up on the fact that this status variable is never accessed, and it actually didn't change it such that the auction status is properly changed. So we still have a bug remaining in our code. And that is not anything against Claude Code in particular. I could have run that exact same sample with Codex. The point here is actually just to show how random large language models really are, and that comparing these two tools with each other doesn't really make a lot of sense from that perspective. Even if large language models were deterministic, the honest truth is that these tools are very competitive with each other. In terms of feature sets, they're both going to be chasing each other, especially when tools like Codex are open sourced. Now, the point of this video is that I wanted to show to you that if you want to become a real AI native engineer, then you should choose one AI code tool and promise to yourself that you're going to master it. Instead of chasing all the hype and changing your tool set every 3 weeks, it's much better to master one tool, because in the end, these AI tools are just meant to help you as a developer get the most out of your productivity. As a senior engineer, what I'm going to do instead is just sit back, wait a couple of months, and then reevaluate my workflow instead of just jumping on Codex CLI because it's the newest, shiniest tool. With that being said, if you disagree with me, leave a comment down below. But if you agree with me, you should definitely check out my AI native engineering community in the link in the description below, where we help you get the most out of AI coding tools to accelerate yourself as a developer and get you ahead in your career.